Well, welcome back to the shop. We're going to be pulling that power steering pump. Yep, time to take it out again. But we're not going to take the pulley off like we did last time. We'll just take the bracket off, pull the two hoses, then pull it out. It's out. So now we'll take a look at it. So it's definitely leaking out of the port there. This one, it's leaking along the pinch weld, what they did for it. Of course, this GM1 is pretty goddamn rusted. There's even another pinhole up there. So we'll see how this goes. So we were just thinking about patching this thing up. Then I realized that, you know, there's a bolt there, there's a bolt there, and this piece unbolts back there. Well, it comes apart. Now the question is that case same size diameter inside as this one? That's the question. Finally was able to get this thing apart, considering this one's junk, because the bearing spun out on this one. This is why we don't have the Dodge one back in, but we'll be able to put the Dodge housing, what doesn't leak, and hopefully put it on this pump and try to get this one off, because the drain port, what is the low pressure side on the Dodge, is in the middle of the unit. But the only thing what matters is the pressure side with the two bolts what bolt together. That's the only thing what technically matters. But we'll see if we can get this apart. Let's see if we can get this thing loose. Oh, we're getting it. There's one bolt. Let's see if we can get this other one. Yeah, they're definitely on tight, but you can see how clean the bolt threads are, but they're just rusted on because the top of them are so rusted. Of course, the flange bolt, that one's going to be interesting.
Self-righteous, self-protection, your
Fine, you don't need that one. Let's see if we can get this last one off. There we go. Bring in the plug. Let's see if we can get the body off. I need a hammer. There's the BFF. Gotta find that. Okay. We found the small BFF. Let's see if we can get this one off. Without dropping it out of the broken vise. It's coming. There we go. This one off. Don't need it no more. Of course, we did lose the string, so we're going to have to find that thing. Okay, found a little string. But that goes with that bolt. I don't know if you can see in there. Right here, there's a magnet. If you do end up pulling these apart, make sure you pull the magnet out and clean it. We'll set that there right now for right now. Let's see if the other cover wants to fit on. Okay, we got the other cover. So mind you, this is the Dodge Dakota. It's a 94 power steering pump cover. This pump, what I put on the 94 bracketry, is actually out of a K5, which is like an 85. Granted, you know, most of this shit should not fit together because of manufacturers, because they build stuff differently. But to us few backyard builders, we've figured out certain parts fit together. So all three holes line up, and the cover will slip back on and seal. Power steering pump fixed! So, we'll clean everything up here real quick, and then we'll put it all back together. So, we got the magnet all nice and clean. Make sure you put it back in the little corner it goes in. Let me grab the other two bolts and we'll put those in instead. So, this one and this one are Dodge. Chevy, Chevy. But they're identical. That's the funny thing. Only thing what's different is the two outports for these. But that's just flow. So, they will bolt right back in. I've got the two other bolts in to line the cover up so I can tap it down and then snug everything down, and then we'll go from there.
So let's get started. I've already got the spring and the valve in already, just so I don't forget them. Make sure you do these bolts one at a time, a couple of turns each, and go back and forth so you get this to sit properly and seat. Man, I can position. Not that tough. Definitely using this one. Now these fittings, have an O-ring in them. Make sure you check your O-ring when you're putting fittings back on, and make sure your threads are clean as well. Done. Now we can bolt it back in the truck. Now it looks like the Dodge pump is back in it, but it really is the Chevy's. Let's get the pump and get it in. Just reinstall your four bolts. They're too short, too longs. Of course, one of your shorts is going to be your ground bolt. Make sure you always put that one up top so you can get to it. Now we tighten everything back up. The ground's on. Look up our lines. Get our pressure side and our low side reconnected. Power steering rack, or box on this case. If you're not going to use a torque wrench, don't over tighten the bolts.
Okay, that was a battle. But we got the two lines on.
get the belt back on. Still only a 15 tensioner. Yeah, stiff fucker. Well, let's put some power steering fluid in it. Damn, I'm such a dick, disrespect. Here comes the big headed nigga that dick. See if this thing will hold. Fluid. Goddamn, I must have the boss this day. Now pimping ain't easy, but it's necessary. Of course, then we're gonna have to see if it will pump it. I mean, the pump should work. That shouldn't be a problem. See if I got any more. I had more than that. Oh, found some more fluid. Hopefully it is power steering fluid what's in it. Yep. I don't talk a lot of shit, but when it's time to get busy with these girls, let's go. Cause I'd rather see a skinhead dead than my niggas wearing blue or red. I got the gift to hit them hoes with, and I'm smelling like a bit of something. Yeah, that's right. I'm standing in the stove, Korean, act so nice. Cause I got potential to blow up a white choke donut. And you know what? I'm cool like that, like this old plant. Let's start it up. He's on. Famous push button. Steering's in. Looks like we did good there. Share, like, and subscribe. Keep watching for more. So, thanks for watching. Till next time, keep it safe.